Bucket. It's an easy game.
And you're the anchor on the team. So how does that feel playing that role and being alongside Radiant and kind of getting the guys to all buy into the team chemistry?
Yeah, you know, we have a system that we like to play into, and the whole team's bought in this year. But yeah, being the anchor, you know, I'm the vocal leader, the one on stage, getting everybody hyped, talking the trash, all that kind of stuff. But no, it's been a great season. We're ready to close out.
There's a lot of talk around Bear to Beast right now. The T-Wolves are also on a massive win streak right now. Like you guys, swept all their way to the finals. What kind of...
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
NBA regular season opener for a couple of teams. Thank you all for tuning in. So happy you're here. I'm ecstatic that you're here.
And I miss you too, Ernie.
And I'm really happy that Kenny and Shaq are here,
too. I miss you too, Ernie.
Thank you.
Me too. In this game, we'll see the Charlotte Hornets going up against the Milwaukee Bucks. Well, for the Bucks, they split the season series against these guys last season, 2 games apiece. Should be a good one tonight. And tonight, guys, Giannis Antetokounmpo. Let's decide on a nickname once and for all. Big fella, you going with the alphabet or the Greek freak?
Greek freak is catchier. But as he gets better, he'll become a super freak.
Oof.
Like my main man Joel from high school.
Yes.
He was a freak.
Yes. He may soon be calling him the perennial MVP.
I think Greek Freak has a better ring.
Yeah, I do too. But if you think, a lot of teams passed on this guy. I know what they're saying to themselves. You know what they're calling themselves? Dummies.
Oh.
That's a good one.
That was quick. And now we go to Kevin Harlan as they get ready for the opening tip.
For this day for a long time. It's opening day in the NBA. Thanks everyone for joining us here in the start of a new season. I'm Kevin Harlan along with Greg Anthony and Brent Berry, our terrific analysts, and David Aldridge is our sideline reporter. We'll see the Charlotte Hornets defending home turf in the Eastern Conference. This game against Milwaukee here, it's their first look to start the season. This team matched up so well during the regular season last year, splitting their 4 games. This should be a terrific battle.
And last year, an entertaining season series between the two ended up battling to a draw.
Yeah, these two teams were so similar in so many ways last season, both in the standings and on the court. very interested to find out who has the edge this time around.
We've got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one. And Milwaukee looking at who they've got. Middleton and Giannis are out on the wings. Ilyasova out there with Brook Lopez, and it's Bledsoe in at the one. And last season, not the one Brook Lopez wanted to have before heading into free agency.
He just never seemed to find a place with the Lakers and saw his minutes decline as he wasn't in their plans. Averaged a career low in terms of minutes played per game last year. I think he still's got a lot to offer and should bounce back closer to his all-star level of output.
Bledsoe against Rozier. Gets it to go from 8 feet. And now just over a minute played here in the first. Bledsoe finds Lopez. It's Antetokounmpo on the wing. Makes it off the glass. Antetokounmpo's got his first points of the night.
Man, defensively so tough to make a decision. What do you want to stop? You come off the pick, Giannis can pass, he can finish. It can really cause you to hesitate.
Now, here's Rozier, and the shot goes down. Rozier's got his second bucket. And so Antetokounmpo will bring it up for Milwaukee. And Antetokounmpo slams it in.
Yeah, he might not be the biggest guy out there, but he's willing to rip that rim off.
Batum against Antetokounmpo. Now, here's Monk. He's guarded closely. To the inside. The kick out to Rozier. Just 5 on the clock. From deep. Doesn't go for him. So Milwaukee will take it the other way. And the wide open shot from Bledsoe. Good on the triple.
Now they can't miss. 4 for 4. And warming up the burners.
For Charlotte, they've gone 2 for 4 from the field so far today. Bledsoe against Rozier. To the inside.
That's good passing down low. He's good at working the ball deep into the post.
Here's Antetokounmpo. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. That's his first foul. The pass to Lopez. Bucks passing it around. Bledsoe looking around. And the slam dunk by Antetokounmpo.
And Giannis adding muscle to his frame for these types of situations. He'll keep getting bigger and stronger, but willing to take the hit.
And Brent, you look at Giannis Antetokounmpo's slashing game, standing, what, maybe a hair under 7 foot tall. How do you even put it into words?
Well, it's hard to imagine a more perfect frame for today's game in terms of getting in transition, having a versatile offensive game, putting it down, getting to the rack. But the one thing that we're anxious to see is whether or not Giannis will develop the type of range from the three-point line that makes it respectable. Other than that, he's pretty much unstoppable.
That's good from Antetokounmpo.
Each year we get to see Giannis come back from a summer and what he's done to up his game. Get a little bit stronger in the weight room, be a little bit better ball handler, play a little bit more aggressively. The guy's competing to be one of the best players in the business.
Now here's Williams. 6 on the shot clock. Batum against Middleton. The rebound by Middleton. Bucks leading by 6. Inside. And that's good from Antetokounmpo on the assist by Middleton. And that's now 9 points for Giannis Antetokounmpo. So Rozier will bring it up for the Charlotte Hornets. So Charlotte calls timeout. They're first.
And Chris Middleton, 2 seasons ago, tore his hamstring completely off the bone. I mean, he's come back and hasn't missed a beat. One of the most well-rounded players you'll see.
Bridges, he's checked in for Charlotte. Milwaukee also making some changes. Robin Lopez is checked in for Lopez. John Luehr comes in for Chris Middleton. And it's Hill in for Eric Bledsoe. Now here's Williams. Bridges with it. Kicks to Zeller. And here is Monk. Williams inside the line. Charlotte again missing. Now let's send it over to David Aldridge, who is able to talk with Mike Budenholzer.
Kevin, he said it was all about taking advantage of what the defense gives them tonight and not forcing things. He said the team that beats us more often than anyone is ourselves. When we lose focus, it's very difficult for us to win. It's something I stress to the guys on the way to the arena. Let's see if they heard him, Kevin. Back to you.
As always, DA, appreciate the good work. So, guys, they want to see their shooting percentage high up there immediately.
Yeah, and it doesn't mean you're just hoping a few guys get hot. It means a commitment to finding good shots.
Well, they're very driven offensively as a team, so you don't have to worry about guys getting too lazy out there. They're just going to keep working and finding those open opportunities.
Opening night is upon us. Every team looking to come out of the gate strong. As we know, only half are going to get to the end.
Don't tell them that, Kevin.
I know you can't.
Let it breathe a little bit.
Yeah.
It is a long season. The teams, as we've seen in the past, sometimes what we're watching here tonight, six or seven members of that team might not be on it come February. So you've got to temper your expectations. Watch the way guys have maybe improved from last season coming into this season. Excited about young teams and the opportunity of their potential, but things can change quickly in this league.
But don't you love the optimism at this time of year?
No doubt about it. Everybody's fired up for the opportunity to show what it is, especially as a player, what you worked on in the offseason to bring it to the hardwood and show your coaching staff the type of work you put in.
Here's Bridges after the basket by Milwaukee. The shot by Monk is no good. 106 left in the first quarter. And Matthews kicks to Antetokounmpo. Goes to the reverse layup and drops it in. Antetokounmpo's got 13.
And from the opening tip, they just crushed it. You see it now on the scoreboard.
Just incredible flow offensively. Everyone's doing their part. Let's see if they can sustain this early momentum.
Bucks leading by 12. Matthews, no one around him. Good, the assist goes to Hill.
They've wasted no time settling into their offense.
Charlotte has gone just 1-of-4 from three-point range here in the first. Hill against Rozier. Will it go? And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
Yeah, good job to take it right at the D.
This is his first chance at the line tonight.
Terry Rozier, shooting two.
Two shots.
First one falls for Charlotte, making some changes. Biombo checks in for Cody Zeller. And ABC subbed in for Marvin Williams. Pat Connaughton, he's checked in for the Bucks. Both good from the line that time. 23 seconds left in the first quarter. Outside Hill. And there are the Bucks with another bucket.
Starting to surge here, and we're only in the first quarter.
And I'm loving what I'm seeing, the passion that they're playing with up and down the floor.
And as we conclude the first quarter, a one-sided game so far. Milwaukee on top, up by 15. And we'll be back with you right after this. And pronouncing Giannis Antetokounmpo's name correctly has been a challenge for many, something he discussed before today's game.
The worst I've ever heard was my rookie year. A guy called me Antetokounmpio, and Kunupi in Greek means mosquitoes. So he basically said anti-mosquito.
And the mosquito, definitely not a good comparison for Giannis.
Yeah, more like a condor. But that last name certainly has a lot of people looking for nicknames.
And welcome back to the second quarter of action. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. Guys, we've seen the Bucks really take control here early.
Yeah, it didn't take them long to get that transition game going.
Well, that's a quick way to build the lead, but Greg, can they sustain this kind of effort all night long? We'll see.
And Milwaukee, looking at who they've got. John Lewis out there with Robin Lopez. Then it's Matthews, then it's George Hill, and it's Connaughton in at the two spot. Here's Hill. To the wing on the left. Lure. Good, and it's Hill picking up the assist. Hill's got three assists tonight.
Like to see George Hill distribute to his teammates a heads-up play there. Well, the Bucks with the superstar talent in Giannis Antetokounmpo, the critical decision this summer for selecting a new coach came down to a very qualified one in Mike Budenholzer, and with all the options out there, nine coaching changes, I think that Bud saw the opportunity in Milwaukee as being a great one to push this team a little bit forward, the talent on the roster tantalizing enough for him to head to Milwaukee after his stint in Atlanta.
Hornets trail by 15. Bridges, no one around him. Off target from outside. And the foul called on ABC. That is his first foul of the game. And some changes here for the Hornets. Michael Kidd-Gilchrist is checked in for Bridges. And it's Batum in for Terry Rozier. A big group substitution here for Milwaukee. Brook Lopez is checked in for Lopez. Ilyasova comes in for Lure. Chris Middleton's checked in for Wesley Matthews. And Eric Bledsoe subbed in for George Hill. Here's Bledsoe. Goes back up, and it's blocked. Now here's Kidd-Gilchrist. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game.
Yeah, they've gotten into a nice flow this quarter.
And so it's Bledsoe. He brings it up for the Bucks. They led by as many as 18 points. Biyombo with the block. Now here's Monk. Guarded by Bledsoe. And Batum kicks to Monk. Washington passes to Kidd-Gilchrist. Lock at six. A floater. Here's Biyombo. And it's sent back by Lopez. Bledsoe outside. That doesn't go either for Bledsoe.
Trying to shoot his way out of this slump, but thus far, not working.
Yeah, I hope it hasn't gone to his head. He may be trying too hard at this point.
Now Batum uses the glass to finish the layup. Batum's got his first bucket of the night.
Got to give a ton of credit to the screener there. That was a perfect pick to give his teammate the space to knock down the shot. Well, the Bucks, this is a franchise that for a long time just was treading water and chasing after a seventh or an eighth seed on the back end of the Eastern Conference playoffs. Not so much anymore. With Giannis Antetokounmpo leading the charge, the opportunity for the Bucks to do some damage in the playoffs is here.
Charlotte calls timeout. And there's always pressure when you have a superstar player, Brent. And the Bucks are trying to capitalize on that window right now.
And I think Giannis, even though he's young, understands that great players are judged on how far they can push their teams. What type of postseason success can the Milwaukee Bucks have around what it is that Giannis can bring to the table? He wants to retire in a Bucks uniform. He said that before, but winning makes that decision a lot easier. And maybe with the coaching change, they'll get there.
Yeah.
that you claim. Why you always in a way? Bad little ways. Bitch, don't make it shake. Ain't bad, but you ain't.
Zeller is checked in for Charlotte. Williams comes in for ABC. And Milwaukee also making a switch. Giannis Antetokounmpo is checked in for Pat Connaughton. Batum against Middleton. Monk, no one around him. Charlotte, no good that time either.
It's a plus five advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Shot is good off the back rim and in.
Yeah, you don't want to leave Middleton from that area. His mid-range game is on fire, draining those shots often.
Monk with the ball. He's got six. Pass to Zeller. All alone. Yep, it goes in, and the Milwaukee lead is cut down to 13 after the bucket is good for Monk.
And Monk's just got a good feel for kind of how to exploit the defense, especially about how quickly he gets his shot off after getting the pass.
And Marvin Williams picks up the foul. That's his first foul. And there's a minute 45 left to play here in the half. Last season, Brent, the addition of two-way contracts, does that make developing players in the G League even more valuable than it was before?
I believe last year, Kevin, that almost 50% of the players in the league, and might have been a smidge more, had some kind of G League experience.
That's terrific.
And that's phenomenal.
Yes.
We're almost close to the 30 for 30 affiliation in the G League. You saw a success story last year in Quinn Cook coming up and getting a contract with the Warriors. This is awesome for the league. They've also upped the minimum contract for G League players to $35,000. All of these signs and the way that teams are using the G League, extremely positive, Kevin.
And they've had assists now on their last three baskets.
Monk kicks to Kid Gilchrist and the foul on Eric Bledsoe. That is his first foul of the game. And some changes here for the Hornets. Hernan Gomez comes in for Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. And it's Rozier in for Monk. Big group substitution here for Milwaukee. Robin Lopez is checked in for Lopez. John Luehr comes in for Ilyasova. Matthews, he's checked in for Chris Middleton. And George Hills subbed in for Eric Bledsoe. Pass to Rozier. Shot clock at six. Outside Williams. That three off the mark.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
Hill kicks to Lewis. It's blocked.
It's not with extreme athleticism that Willie gets to that shot, but the anticipation and the timing, those help.
Passes it to Rozier. Back to Batum. The kick out to Rozier. From outside, off the mark. And we've reached halftime in this one. Bucks lead by 15. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, thanks. Here with Mike Budenholzer. Your defense has been very good. Why has that happened?
Well, you know, I think our guys are committed on that end. Everybody's active, everybody's covering for each other, and we know how important it is.
Mike, we'll see if it continues in the next quarter. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David, and we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Ernie Johnson here with Shaq and Kenny, and a favorite time of the year as we're halfway through one of the first games of this fresh NBA season. It was a big-time first quarter for Giannis Antetokounmpo. He had 13 points, 2 assists, and 4 rebounds. Kenny, your thoughts on the Bucks' first half?
They looked like they were playing an easy game of pitch and catch out there. The playmakers and finishers were in sync on every level. The assist disparity, now that was big. Now that's the reason why it's a blowout right now, and they play well.
Shaq, let's get your insight on Charlotte.
Sloppy ball, way too many wasted possessions, chucking up threes, missing them.
I could hit more threes than that, Ernie. I hope they're talking right now about getting the ball inside, because that's what it's going to take. If they were hitting more threes, that'd be a different story. But if if was a fifth, Ernie, you know the rest.
That about wraps it up. Time now for the second half of the game. We go to Kevin Harlan for the call.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. You look at Antetokounmpo in this one. He's been everywhere.
And the defense was soft in that first half, and he took advantage every chance he could. And boy, was he throwing it down hard.
Well, it's one thing to drive, but it's another thing to drive and dunk. So let's see if he can keep that going here in the third.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. Monk is out there with Terry Rozier. Then there's Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. Then there's Hernan Gomez. And it's Batum in at the small forward. So that's who James Borrego starts the second half with. And Ilyasova kicks to Antetokounmpo. Just four to shoot. It's tipped. And here's Batum to the middle. Shot's good by Hernan Gomez. Hernan Gomez has got the first points to start out the third quarter for Charlotte.
This is where Willie does his best work. As I say, Kevin, he's Willie good inside.
That's right, Brent. Count that bucket. And the Bucks lead by 15.
If you're going in amongst the trees, you have got to be aggressive.
Well, he's also crafty with how he approaches it. Right there, he uses just the right move to lay it in.
Got that one up quick. Bledsoe's got 4 points this quarter.
Shooting off the pass, that means Bledsoe set himself early and was ready to let it fly. When you think about a coach looking into the eyes of one of his players and telling him to match up with Giannis Antetokounmpo and all the things that he brings to the table. That's a long night of restlessness before you match up. Press up on him, he'll blow by you in transition. He's at the rim in two dribbles. Tough to stop that kid.
Charlotte calls timeout. Right, Antetokounmpo covers so much ground, Brent. He can almost go the entire length of the court in two dribbles.
But once he gets around towards the rim, his reach can make it seem like defenders aren't even there. Not just one defender, but multiple defenders. So it's unfair already, and you add that athleticism to what he can do. Wow, unstoppable offensive force.
Bridges is checked in for Nicholas Batum. And just who is providing all the playmaking here tonight? Let's look at the breakdown between the front and backcourt for the Bucks.
And their bigs have actually played a significant role with their passing. That frees the guards to come up off screens and cut to the rim and kind of flipping the script here offensively.
Hornets trail by 19. And we're about a minute and a half here into the second half. There's the pass to Monk. Bridges against Bledsoe. They get it back. Kidd-Gilchrist goes to the reverse layup and claps it in.
Man, he's got such a great touch and feel around the basket. He made that reverse look easy.
Bledsoe against Rozier. Got a piece of it. And that's out of bounds. Milwaukee will retain possession.
Bucks ball.
A moment now to see how the schedule is looking coming up for the Charlotte Hornets. On Friday, they'll begin a long road trip starting in Orlando and going up against the Magic. And then on Saturday, they'll face off against Jimmy Butler and the Miami Heat.
And when you look at that Raptors matchup, it's going to be an all-out battle. And you just hope they are rested and able to execute their game plan, as it's going to be a tremendous challenge.
Yeah, Giannis has the hard hat on right now, going to work so good, so long, and just terrorizing the D.
Rozier kicks to Monk, fires for three, rebounded by the Bucks.
And a really smart defender there. He just reads the play, wastes no time trying to blow it up.
And what I like best is that he does it completely under control. Really gives the shooter nowhere to turn to.
Well, we're into the third quarter, just over 2.5 minutes played. And so the ball goes out of bounds. Lopez touched it last. And Clark, while we have a moment, let's show you the list of players who put up the most points last year. Fifth is Giannis Antetokounmpo.
And looking back, his points per game really underscored the fact that he never took a game off. I mean, one special performance after another all season long.
Here's Monk.
And he really seems to just have lost his touch at halftime.
His three-pointer is off the mark.
Just doesn't seem to be shooting it with confidence, and his shots are going all over the place in this period.
Here's Lopez, and a great assist by Antetokounmpo as that one goes in. And that's now 8 points for Brook Lopez. For Charlotte, they've gone 2-7 from the field in the third. That leaves room for improvement, certainly. Rozier, the pass to Monk. Can they get it? Up top, Kidd Gilchrist. Just five to shoot. Pass to Bridges. Lets the three fly. Gets hauled in by Ilyasova.
+8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Second half here. We're just over 3.5 minutes into it. Antetokounmpo can't get it to go.
You got to make that. The defense was far from terrible, but, man, that's an easy shot.
You know, watching Miles Bridges, he just brings so much energy to the team.
High motor guy, very aggressive. You know, a bit of a tweener, which in a positionless world could be a good thing. Explosive, strong, athletic. I think his best basketball is ahead of him.
Got to give a ton of credit to the screener there. That was a perfect pick to give his teammate the space to knock down the shot.
And Milwaukee calls their first time out of the game.
And he's probably looking at some matchups on the floor he'd like to take advantage of.
I'm interested in what he's seeing and then what kind of play they run coming out of this timeout.
An almost entirely new group in now for Charlotte. Biombo is checked in for Hernan Gomez. Zeller comes in for Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. Washington's checked in for Bridges. And it's Batum in for Monk. Rozier against Hill. 1:43 left to play in the third. Here's Connaughton, defended by Batum. Got a piece of it. And there's the foul. It goes on Wesley Matthews. That is his first foul of the game. +1:29 left in the third quarter. Biombo kicks to Rozier. Pass to Zeller. Shot clock at 6. Charlotte needs to get a shot.
George Hill, phenomenal instincts defensively and did a great job of challenging to throw that shooter off.
And this is what happens when you fail to block out.
Defensive rebounding, just as important as causing the miss in the first place.
He kicks it to Lewis. Pass to Connaughton. Milwaukee needs to get off a shot here, and the Bucks miss again. And it's Batum with the ball, bringing it up for Charlotte. 26 seconds left in the third, and that one good.
They're consistently finding ways to get the ball inside and taking full advantage.
Hill looking around. Right wing, here's Connaughton. And the three off target. And so it's Milwaukee holding a big 18-point lead to close the quarter. The scoring has been tremendous, and they are shooting lights out with very high accuracy. And don't go away. We'll be right back. And let's take now this moment to bring up our State Farm assist of the game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Well, a great job with the eyes. And what separates great playmakers, as we know, Greg, is peripheral vision.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. Hornets trail by 18 on the floor for Milwaukee starting the fourth quarter. We've got George Hill, Robin Lopez out there with John Lewis. Then it's Matthews, and it's Connaughton in at the two. Batum wide open, he fires. That's good, and it's Rozier with the assist. Rozier's got four assists in the game. Talk about what it means to be a good teammate, Brent. You've played with good ones. You've played with bad ones. I've always thought you were team first when you played.
Well, I appreciate that, Kevin. There's just an idea about what it is that you can contribute to the team. I think you always have to accentuate those ideals. Your approach on a daily basis has to be consistent. And if you're a starting player, it's one mentality. And if you're somebody that plays off the bench, you have to come to practice every day to push the guy that's in front of you and wait for your opportunity. But most of the time, it's that kind of consistency with which you come to work and the attitude of making sure that I want to make any kind of contribution I can for our team's success. That usually is a pretty good formula for a good teammate.
Changes here for the Bucks. Ilyasova comes in for Lure. And Antetokounmpo subbed in for Pat Connaughton. Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. Mike Budenholzer had some words for his team during the break. He still wants them to be aggressive and assertive on offense. He said, I don't want us to get content with this lead. Build on it. Don't give them any chance of getting back in this thing. Kevin?
The pass to Washington. Charlotte moving the ball around. Down to five on the shot clock, and the call will be against Robin Lopez. That'll be his second foul of the game. Down low and stolen by Ilyasova.
If you could stay active on defense, good things usually happen. Right there, quick hands helped alter what would have been a sure two there.
Lopez dishes to Matthews. Outside Hill. 4 on the clock. Over Rozier. That one, no good. And the Hornets now going the other way. They get to take on the Magic in Orlando after this one. And that'll be game one of a 4-game road trip. Back to Batum. But they get it back. The three gets hauled in by Ilyasova. Bucks leading by 15 to the paint. And it's Lopez. That time on the assist by Hill. Hill's got his fourth assist in this one. Game moves along. 2 minutes gone here in the fourth. And the Hornets call time here. And Robin Lopez, one of those dirty work type of big men, rebounding, defending, a lot of grit, setting screens. He does it all.
Yeah, unselfish. He does know his role. It just makes things easier for his teammates. Has his quirks, but has proven to be a great teammate.
Charlotte making some changes. Hernan Gomez is checked in for Zeller. Kid Gilchrist comes in for Marvin Williams. And Monk's subbed in for ABC. Milwaukee also making some changes. Brooke Lopez is checked in for Lopez. Chris Middleton comes in for Wesley Matthews. And Eric Bledsoe subbed in for Hill. Rozier kicks to Monk. To the inside. Hernan Gomez finds Kid Gilchrist over Ilyasova. With 1 second left, shot's good by Hernan Gomez.
Well, beating everybody to the ball, Willie doesn't always get his number called, so he's got to put in the extra work and find these efforts on the offensive glass.
Antetokounmpo against Batum. Down it goes. Nice one there from Antetokounmpo.
And every move he makes looks like the right one at this point.
Yeah, shooting at a very high percentage right now. This one extending the lead.
And the foul on Eric Bledsoe. That'll be his second foul of the game. And it's Brooke Lopez with the foul. That is his first foul of the game.
And the next one puts him in the bonus.
Here's Hernan Gomez. Kicks it to Monk. 5 on the clock. Pass to Rozier. Knocked loose. And that's out of bounds. Charlotte will retain possession. And so here's Charlotte. Here in the fourth, they've allowed just 4 points.
And seems to be forcing just a little bit out there. He needs to play a little calmer, a little smarter, with a little bit more poise if they're going to win this one.
Bledsoe outside. Shoots over Kid Gilchrist. No good from Bledsoe.
And he completely threw the timing off on that jumper. That is how you D up.
Playing with tremendous aggressiveness without fouling. That's an excellent job.
Bledsoe against Rozier. Shot clock at 6. Down low. Here's Hernan Gomez. That's good. And it's Rozier with the assist.
Now how about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
Bledsoe passes to Ilyasova. Kidd Gilchrist against Middleton. 1:53 left here in the fourth quarter. No good on that one. And Batum kicks to Rozier. Pass to Monk. 14 feet away. The kick out to Rozier. And it's off from three-point range.
And tonight's battle is going to end with a very clear winner, leaving nothing to chance. Impressive win for Milwaukee.
In the end, they had a better shooting percentage, and that's what made the difference. Sometimes, you know, things go your way. The other team wasn't catching many lucky breaks themselves.
Yeah, and Kevin, not all about luck. I thought their overall shot selection was better.
And it'll go down as their first official win of the new year.
They can chalk this one up, but these two teams will see plenty more of one another before the season's over.
And what a tremendous standout performance it was for Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Just a really solid effort on the offensive end. He was getting any shot that he wanted.
Wesley Matthews on the wing. Passes it to Connaughton. Stolen by Allen. And there it is for him. For Milwaukee, they've gone just 33% from the field in the fourth quarter so far. They are 2 of 6. Connaughton kicks to Lopez. Here's Hill. Mack grabs the miss. So Mack will bring it up for the Charlotte Hornets. Here in the fourth, they've allowed just 4 points. And it's in there.
This is not the team we've been watching for most of the night.
It's a shame because this is the team we expected to see fighting on every possession. I think it's just too late.
And Luer kicks to Hill. And finished off by Luer.
Yeah, with this lead, that's probably going to do it. Fans heading for the exits.
Now the team came in fired up from the opening tip. You could see the focus. You're ready to do battle.
Bridges shot. Good.
Not only a jump shooter, Bridges also dependable at knowing how to get it done inside.
Outside Hill. And so it's the Bucks taking care of business in this one. And in the win, a comfortable win in what was, I think, gee, a pretty hostile environment.
It really was. You know, it's never going to be easy on the road, but they didn't have too many problems with that tonight.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Here with Eric Bledsoe. Eric, a strong performance tonight. What's been the difference?
We're getting out of transition, you know, trying to get defensive stops. And everybody's just playing their game.
And it showed tonight, Eric. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. And that about does it for the first game of the new NBA season. For Greg Anthony, Brent Berry, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thank you for watching the NBA, presented by 2K Sports. So long.